Welcome to LBCC Learning. Today it's a brief of part A of paper 8 of CA Intermediate. The paper 8 is a combination of two parts, that is financial management and economics. But I would be dealing with only with financial management, that is part A, and therefore the syllabus of part A of paper 8. Okay, so this part A has only two modules with 10 chapters. Only the last chapter, the 10th chapter, has 6 units to it, specifically divided into 6. So let's just check out what's there in the first module. Okay, so module 1, obviously the main subject, it's the scope and objectives of financial management. 2, chapter number, it's the different types of financing that we have. It's the different types of financing that we can opt for or is available for the business. And this part is the major work of the financial managers. Financial analysis and planning. Basically, the ratio analysis. How do we use the ratios and what can be interpreted out of the data that we have. Okay, now we go to the fourth chapter, the cost of the capital. We know there are several ways to get them. We know there are several sources of funds for the business. Now, it's not that we go and just take funds from people. We have to check what is the cost, that is the terms and conditions of getting that capital for our business. Only when we completely understand the cost of the capital that we are going to take, we'll only understand how it can be used for our business more rationally. Okay, now it's the fifth chapter, and mind you, fifth and sixth chapters are basically decisions regarding finance, financing. The fifth chapter is regarding capital structure of the financing decision part. Capital structure means, just like structure for any human being, yeah, there is a structure for the funds involved in a business. Okay, that's what we are going to see in this fifth chapter. And the sixth chapter, the last chapter of this module, module 1, is the leverages part. It's an analysis of how do we use different kinds of funds for our purpose. Okay, so with that, module 1 is over. Now we move to the module 2. Under that, we have the seventh chapter, another type of decision, investment decisions. We have the finances, we know the cost of. Now we have to really put our brains when and how much to put. Okay? We should be really thinking about the future, the impact of our decisions of finance, on finance or funding, whether to invest and how much to invest and when to invest and what to invest. Okay, so now we are moving to the eighth. One of the major and very often heard, that is the cliche, is that risk in the business. So you have to understand, or we have to find out the ways of taming or adjusting with this risk factor in the business. So the eighth chapter is about risk analysis in capital budgeting. We'll come to know what is capital budgeting during our course. For now, I give you a brief. We have the capital. Capital is the fund outlay that we are going to use for the business. Now we have to really be careful that the whole fund cannot be used for only one single purpose at a one single particular time. No, the business is all about using the best resources for best possible output, right? So capital also is one of the resources very much needed for the business. For very much needed means day-to-day operations till the long-term impact. All the stuff is basically related to the finance. And finally, what we are really relieved is that we get the money back, right? The fund is coming back. Again, we have so many decisions on that also. We will see that. So this particular part of putting the finance, it has to be really budgeted. It's not straight away simply served in a single plate like that. Okay, so that is capital budgeting. How much, when, where, to whom, and why? That is capital budgeting. As I've already mentioned before, the 9th chapter is about the money that is coming back from the business. Money comes back in the business? Yeah, definitely. You are making the business. You are making a product. You are giving a service. So naturally, you are pricing it and you get the price paid by the consumer or the customers. Therefore, that money is coming back. That money is not going to be used only for the purpose of the business. It has to be given back. Yeah, in the form of dividends. So the 9th chapter is about the 3rd type of decisions, dividend decisions. Now we come to the 10th and the final chapter of this module, management of working capital. We've been talking about so many kinds of funds, cash, everything. But day to day, for the process to happen, for the business to run, for the product to come out, you need money. And there, the capital should work, and that is working capital. And that chapter is management of working capital. Under that, we have 6 units separately. The first one is, naturally, you need to know what the financial implications of the term called working capital. So it is an introduction to working capital. Second unit is regarding treasury and cash management. The third, one of the most important thing, management of inventory, all the goods that is coming from different parts, the supply chain, all that has happened, the goods that you need for the product to be produced with, that is the management of inventory. So you have both one, management of receivables. It's not always the business is happening only you pay and you get the thing. No, there are times that people need more time for payment, and so when you give time for that, you're actually giving credit to them, and so you have to receive from them, right? The receipt happens sometimes later. So that is management of receivables. And the 5th chapter is, now when we have receivables, when we give time for the people to give us back the money, same way we expect some people to give us time for our payment to them also. So the 5th chapter is regarding management of payables, otherwise known as the creditors. And the last and the final unit of this module, or the whole of this part, is financing of working capital. From where and how and when do we get the fund for working capital? Okay, so this is a very brief. So we have seen what we have for the paper. I hope you will keep watching my videos for finding out what these chapters are about. Okay, so once again, I am requesting you to subscribe my channel, like my channel, share my channel, and if you do have any comments, if you have any sort of doubts, please do inbox me. And then the bell icon, please don't forget to click that bell so that you get the notifications on time. Bye.